So a lot of you may have bought recently graphics from places like Creative Fabrica or Creative Market. I'm going to show you in this video how those work in different graphic apps. So I'm going to take five graphic apps in this video, and I'm going to drag in some SVGs and see how they work. Can you change the color? Can you size it? What happens? And so on. You don't want to miss this. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I wanted to show you the differences between five different apps online that you can use for your digital downloads or your downloads that you've done for with SVGs. So specifically SVGs, and SVGs are scalable vector graphics. So they're vectors, they can scale, and you're supposed to be able to change the color, and you can in some of these apps. I'm gonna see if we can change the color in all of these apps. We're gonna do Canva, Kittle, Inkscape, Figma, and Affinity Designer, and I'm going to show you the differences between all of them and see which one you have and what kind of the limitations are for each of these. So let's go to Creative Fabrica first. I'm going to find a couple of SVGs, one black and one that's colored, and then we're going to download those and then bring them into the apps. All right, so here we are on Creative Fabrica or Fabrica. You can see I'm on this page, it's the home page. And there's lots of different things on here, but we're gonna focus on graphics. So a lot of you may have bought some graphics because you know, Black Friday and they were on sale and so on. So let's go look at graphics. I'm gonna just turn all of these off and just do graphics. Boom. Okay, so we're just looking for a very simple SVG graphic. This one could work, or this one, I like this one actually. Let's go on here. You can see lots of different colors. So when you bring it into your graphics app, you're assuming that you can change those colors too. We're gonna see if that works. So I'm gonna download this one, boom. And also I want just a straight black and white. Yeah, let's just do this one. Well, no, that's not black. Let's do this one. Black and white, looks like a sticker. I'm gonna download this too. You can see it's just black. Hopefully no white outline. I'm guessing, yeah, I think it's just black. Black t-shirt. So let's download this one too. It says that there's an SVG. So we're gonna take the SVGs from both of these and bring them into different applications. We're gonna start with Canva first. So let's go into Canva and see what happens when we drag these in. All right, so here I am on Canva. First, I wanted to show you how it downloaded. I should have showed you that before, but you can see right here, it downloaded in a zip file. The first one was that Faith in God. You can see the SVG right here. I also have PNGs and EPSs. I also have 12 SVGs or 12 folders, each with a SVG and PNG. I'm gonna open up one. I'll open up the PNG just so you can see it. So you can see this one right here, this PNG has some color in it. So kind of like a muted vintage color. So we're gonna see if we can change those colors in Canva. And the other one is just black and white. This Faith in God, I'll open that too. Oh, you can see that this is just a PNG of that. Let's see if it has that white outline. Oh, right here. So this is the actual one. It's just black, no background. And this is the PNG, but we're gonna pull in the SVG. There's also the SVG version right here. And we're gonna do that. Okay, so let's get rid of this. And let's just open up a new one. I'm gonna create a design in Canva, custom size, 4,500 by 5,400 if you're gonna make it for t-shirts. All right, so let's find that again and I'll drag it in. So first, let's do the Faith in God one, which is black. I'm gonna pull it in here. You can see it pulls it in right into Canva and it's scalable, it's nice, it's big. So that part's okay. Can we color it? I think we can. Yeah, but it colors the whole thing. You can't go and like change just one thing on here. One hack that you could do is you could crop it, right? And then do just that, but sometimes you can see right there it's not doing it well. So sometimes cropping doesn't work. You could do maybe these three in one color and then the other ones in another color, but as far as coloring each individual part of this SVG, it's not going to work. So let's see if it works for the one that does have color, because this was just one color. Let's do the Boho Christmas one. Okay, so here's a SVG. I bring it in. Remember, it's this one. And right away, this is a SVG. And let's see if I can color it. You can see it's gonna color the whole thing again. I can't go and pick Well, if I did black, it does those colors, but I can't go and pick the other colors on it, right? There's no way for me to like say I want this as a red one or a different one. It just colors the whole thing as a SVG. If you do black, it remembers the colors back here. So that's your limitation on bringing things into Canva, is you can scale it and you can color it if it's one color. And if you want the multiple colors, it's not gonna work on Canva, at least this way that we're doing. There may be another way. If you know another way to color all of it, let me know in the comments. But as far as like being really simple and clicking on these colors, that's not the way to do it. So let's try another app. Let's go into Kittle and see what happens. All right, so here I'm on Kittle. We're gonna do a new project, the same thing. Go in here, pick a pod preset. I'm gonna do 4,500 by 5,400. I'm gonna drag in the first one, the Faith in God one, SVG, right? Drag it in here. And it should do kind of the same thing, yep. And so you can scale it, but can you color it? Let's see the color here. And yes, you can color the whole thing, but you can't, as far as I know, double click on it and change anything else on here. So it's kind of like Canva in that way, where you just, you know, click the whole thing. So let's see what happens when you bring in a multicolored thing. There's the Boho Christmas. Wow, so much better. You can see right away it recognizes all the colors. So right here, if I wanted to make that red more red, or this yellow, pale yellow, more yellow, let's see, I can do that, right? And it's really smart, actually. It just grabbed all the colors. So now I can just make the colors the way I want it. So a little better than Canva, and it recognizes all the colors. So pretty cool. I'm gonna give Kittle a plus. Let's see what something else does. I'm gonna go into Inkscape now and show you what happens if you have Inkscape, if you pull in an SVG there. So this is the Inkscape website. It's not actually an app that's online. You're gonna have to download it to your computer. So you can see Inkscape is totally free. People like to use this because it's kind of like a free Illustrator app. And you can download right here. It's always free. I have an older version, so I'm gonna open that up, but hopefully it does the same thing. So if you don't have it, download it here. If you don't wanna download it, you can just watch me to see how it works. So I'm gonna open it up on my computer and then show you how Inkscape works with SVGs. So here we have Inkscape. I opened up a new document and I'm gonna just drag in those SVGs like I did with the other one. So first the Faith in God one, drag it in. It's asking me about this SVG input, and I'm just gonna hit okay. And there we go, we can scale it. And let's see if we can get in here. Now, with Inkscape, I can actually go in here and pick the specific ones. So if I want God a different color, I can come in here and pick any of the colors down here. So let's, you know, check it out. So they have their color pat down here. Now you could change it wherever you want it, but I have mine down here. So this one's even better than what we had before with Kittle and Canva, is I can actually pick the words here. And let's say I want to make that blue and that yellow, right? So you may not want to do that, but you have the option to change that. So I'm gonna guess that the other one, you can do the same thing. So I'm gonna delete this. And let's do the Boho one SVG, drag it in. Same screen here. You can see you can do either one of these, but I'm not gonna link to the file. I wanna embed it, so, or include it. Boom, I got it here. Now, same thing, you can double click on these and change those colors. So right away, I have the option to change all of it, right? So I can just change that one right there. Maybe I want to make that one blue and so on, make that one a different color and so on. So Inkscape gives you total freedom to change any color, even the black and white one. I could change and go in and double click on it and change just one element of it. So just that heart, or just this, or in the other one, just the words. So this one's even better. It's a graphic design app, so of course, I expect it to do that. And if you have Illustrator, which is, this is kind of based off of, I would expect that you can do the same thing as well. So let's get into another app that's online, and this is Figma. You may not have heard of Figma, but it's online and it's totally free. I'm gonna show you how to use that as well and what happens with the SVG. All right, so this is Figma. You can go to figma.com and you can sign in and you can get started for free. I've already signed in, so I'm gonna remove this here. So first things first, we're gonna create a new design file. We're gonna come in here and we'll just put it in my team folder. Do it there, and then we're gonna need a artboard, so I'm just gonna do frame here, boom. All right, so let's drag in the SVGs and see what happens. So I'm gonna do SVG for the Faith of God again, drag it in. All right, so can we double click on some of these? Yes, we can come in here and click on each of these letters, and I can color each of these, so I don't have to do the cropping thing like we did with other. I can come in here and double click and hold down shift and, you know, color this whole thing. The color palette's right here. Very powerful, right? Color my star, whatever yellow it is. Perfect. All right, so we know it does that. I'm gonna assume that it can do the same thing for the rainbow. Let's bring it in with SVG. Boom. All right, can I double click on this? Yes, I can change it to whatever color I want. So pretty cool, right? Any of these. Double click on here, change it to blue, red, whatever, right? So there you go. So SVGs work really well with Figma. If you want to design in Figma, you have the flexibility to change the colors. Last one, let's do Affinity Designer. This is the one I use, and let's see what happens. All right, so for those who don't know about Affinity Designer, it's an app that you download, same like Inkscape, but this one actually isn't free. This one costs you money. And they have a sale on right now. It's about, let's see what how much it costs right now. So I'm gonna go buy now. Originally it's $70, right now it's $41.99. So it isn't free, but in the long run, I think it's a one-time payment, you know, about $50 or so, or $70, depending when you get this. And I think it pays for itself. I'm gonna show you what it does with SVGs, but it does a lot more if you wanna see my videos. I have tons of videos on it. I'll put a link up here for my Affinity video, but I use this personally, so I wanted to show you how it works with SVGs. So here's the Affinity Designer app. I have it open on my desktop. It's another one that you have to download and open up in your desktop, so it's not online. There's also an iPad version, which I have a video for that as well. They're gonna work about the same. So I'm gonna show you what happens when you bring in an SVG. That we're doing the Faith in God again, the last one here, and double click on it. Now, this is something that you may not wanna just drag it in like the other ones. I would suggest that you actually copy and paste it. So I'm gonna, this is the actual SVG. So what it's doing when you drag it in is it actually has its own thing. You can see right here, embedded. So I actually don't like embedded. I'm gonna grab all of these and copy and go back here and paste it. And that just works better because I don't have to mess up that. I have my own one on here now. So I'm gonna make it bigger. So now when I double click on it, you know, I can change it. I'm not messing with the original. I'm messing with this one right here. But you can see if I go to colors, I can pick my own colors here and do that. I can change individual ones just like we did with all the other apps. So this one does it as well, where I can come in here and click on each individual one. Now I can do other things like gradients and other things like that. Like if I had, and I'm sure you could do this with other ones that actually have gradients, but if I wanted to do the gradient tool, I can do that too, right on here. So I can change the top one here to blue, or the bottom one to blue, and the top one here to whatever color I want here. Let's say red, right? So I can do gradients, I can do colors, I can do whatever I want in this app right here. So let's see, you're probably guessing that we can do the same thing with the other one, and you wouldn't be wrong. So let's do the SVG for the Boho Christmas. And it, again, when I bring it in like that, it's gonna be embedded. I don't want it to be embedded. So we're gonna copy this right here, the embedded one. And I'm gonna come in here and get rid of this one and paste it so that I'm not tied to that embedded one. And the reason you may wanna do that and just have the original one, change the original. This is gonna be the original one in the way that we did it. If we changed here, then it would change the one that on was on this page, but now that I replaced it, this is the original one. So I can mess this up without messing up the original, if that makes sense. So I can come in here and change any of the colors too, right? So there you go, all of them. Let's recap what each one did. So if you're using Canva, you can only color the SVGs on the full thing for the Faith in God. That you can color change the whole thing on that one. And the same thing with the other one that was multicolored, you can only change the whole object. The whole SVG will change one color at a time. Now on Kittle, it was just a little bit different. The first one, you could only change the whole thing because that one was only one color. But the second one, which was multicolored, you could change each colored section. So if anything was a red color, it would pick up on that, and you can change anything that's that red color to another color and so on. Now for the other three, they kind of work the same. So Inkscape, you could change the color on each object, each individual object. So you could go down and just change the O in God, or the D, or the piece of the rainbow in here, or each individual heart on the Mary. It worked on both of them, and you can change. And that's the same for Figma, as well as Affinity Designer. And if you have Illustrator, I'm sure it works the same way. So there you go. Hopefully this video is really helpful so you can see the limitations on what you can do with an SVG. Now SVGs are great because you can scale it and color it. But if you only have Canva, you may want to use some of these other apps if you want the flexibility to change the colors on each individual piece of it. So I do have some videos on some of these. I have a Kittle playlist right here, but if you want to see me do other videos for some of these other apps, let me know in the comments. I can do one for Figma. I got some for Affinity Design already, and I haven't done very many for Inkscape, so let me know those in the comments. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.